Well, good morning. I'm Bob Rink, chair of the Álamos committee with Scottsdale Sister Cities. And along with me is my sister, Katherine Callingham. We work side by side in coordinating the activities between Scottsdale and Álamos. And anyway, I'm going to give you an overview of what we're doing pretty much currently as far as sister cities. I do not know intimately the history when it started, but we have a little bit of an introduction to that in the next slide. And so you pick up that the relationship began in 69, the mayors that were involved. And over the years, delegations from both cities have crossed the border, developing strong friendships, sharing each other's culture and skills, recognizing and fulfilling different community needs. For over 50 years, of friendship and understanding between our two communities has continued through relationships. So this is a gazebo that's in a major park in Scottsdale, the McCormick Railroad Park, and it's a representation of Álamos and our friendship.
And the Álamos gazebo that was built here was designed after the Álamos gazebo. Next slide.
Next. This is one of our former mayor, or Álamos mayors, Benjamin Anaya, and his wife, son at the time, and his sister. So areas we're going to focus on with our projects is educational, cultural, humanitarian, medical, and governmental delegation exchanges. Next. So this is a student here in Álamos writing a pen pal note in English to her pen pal in Scottsdale.
So we have an exchange with Pueblo Elementary School in Scottsdale, which is a bilingual school. And down here it's with Escuela Bartolome 1 year. And then we've also had video calls with these pen pals, setting it up down here and talking to the students up in Scottsdale.
And one of these exchanges led to
Pueblo Elementary Schools coming down with 12 different family groups and visited their pen pals and got to stay in homes.
And a major thrust is the high school exchanges. We've been doing them every year except for the years of the pandemic. And we're starting up this year, we hope. They'll be here. The Scottsdale kids will be here in March, and the Álamos kids will be in Scottsdale in April.
So here's an Álamos student in, excuse me, a Scottsdale student in Álamos working with English classes.
Next. Thank you.
Let me keep going. Here's a Álamos student in Scottsdale working at Pueblo Elementary School with Spanish classes.
And this is a high school chemistry class where in Scottsdale, where the Álamos students are helping them with an experiment. And the next one is what they did is made up some silly putty. Next. And traditionally, each delegation visits that community's mayor, and they have a discussion for about a half hour, exchanging ideas and talking about their trips and experiences.
And the Álamos students, when they're in Scottsdale, they get to visit Mayor Lane as well, the mayor as well.
And here's a Scottsdale student reading in English from a English book to some students at?
And it's Lazaro Cardenas at primary school. So they go in and promote the exchange programs down at the elementary, secondary school levels. And those kids remember that now that are on the exchange programs.
And here's a Álamos student working with some Pueblo students, elementary school students, on their Spanish. And we, when they were, the Scottsdale students were here in Álamos 1 year, there was the year of, or the festival of the Jaguar. So these guys are buddies, they're exchange mates. Next. When we're up in Scottsdale with the Álamos groups, we usually take a day trip up to the Grand Canyon. And so this is them experiencing it. This is the Bright Angel Trail going down through the canyon. And the recently we've been able to take the kids out for the day to visit a village from Guadajito Village. And this woman is teaching them how to grind corn into maize.
To make tortillas. They started from scratch. And they went with all the Kobach teachers and students, as well as our students and teachers.
Next. We also do community service projects on each side of our exchanges. This is the Scottsdale kids in front of Deep preparing food baskets for delivery to the needy.
Outlying villages.
They've also visited a senior center, and the idea is to have some outside voices coming in and entertaining. Sometimes we'll have some musicians in the group and they'll play songs. It's a lot of fun. In Scottsdale, we typically go to the Handlebar J restaurant, which has country swing evenings once a week. And so the kids are learning to dance country western style. And this is our Scottsdale kids and our Álamos exchange mates. Down here, we celebrated Halloween, and here's their party here made up. It was a lot of fun.
One of our exchange students from Álamos, Diana, her father has a hot dog stand, had some training from Navajoa. She's up performing on the PA system in the high school in Scottsdale, and the principal, Renee, was accompanying her. Next slide. Here are students in Álamos enjoying hot dogs from her father's stand. She's gone, they have a amateur competition program nationally. I don't know what it's called, but she was runner up for the whole country with her singing. And Álamos was on edge watching every night of the competition as she moved up.
So we have some chance to experience Mexican food. This is a carne asada barbecue at Lynn Werbs' house. Anyway, we had some good time. And we typically go over to the beach.
Here in Alamos, when we have the students here in Álamos, they go have a day out at the beach.
How long is each exchange?
A week. They go up, they come down either for their fall break or spring break. And the Álamos students go up in the second week of Semana Santa. So the schools are in attendance on both sides, and the kids going during their vacation, the travelers.
That's good. Okay, next one would be good. So we're looking into the possibilities of an exchange between Itasca and Scottsdale Community College, and what were the areas, but.
Itasca is a university, a technical university here, supported by the mines, and they have engineering degrees. They have degrees in tourism and culinary science. And Scottsdale Community College has a really good culinary program, and we're hoping that they've been working for a couple of years to try and get some exchanges going there.
So here's some of the things we have examples of them in some of the slides anyway. So we'll be looking at exhibitions at the Mexican consulate that are exhibited in Phoenix offices.
We bring Alamos artists and artisans up to Scottsdale, and then we've also brought the Alfonso Dorado performance up to Scottsdale. We've brought Estudiantinas up to Scottsdale, and then we're bringing jazz musicians from Scottsdale down to Alamos for the Alamos International Jazz Day Festival.
Next.
This, here's an example, or the last exhibit we had of the Alamos artists and artisan exhibits at the Mexican Council in Phoenix, Alicia Sanchez. This is the consulate's gallery, Fernando Quiroz's work. Keep going. Here's Ceci Anaya's sculpture. Keep going. And Metzli Estrada's work. Keep going. And then here's the Alamos International Jazz Day Festival. So the culture we bring down here.
Wow, excellent. So there's a range of performers. Just, you can kind of go through this, Errol.
Okay.
We typically have 2 days of performances. Doc will perform out on the plaza, and then one night in the Palacio, they'll have a New Orleans style jazz band parade through town. We have workshops for students. We'll usually go out to Kobach and have works. Workshops. Okay. Oh, we'll get it.
When is this special?
This year it's March 10th and 11th, Friday and Saturday.
Continue, Errol. That's good. Next, yeah. And then practice session in Catherine's gallery. This is the big thriller band from Navajoa after their performance. And we're intertwining Alamos and Scottsdale.
Ramon Alfantar and Squeak. They'll have jam sessions after the evening performance, either at the Hacienda, at Le Bleu, or at the, used to be the Los Tesoros, probably over at the La Nación. This is some of the workshops up at the Casa de la Cultura. Doc wanted art included into it. We had Rocky Point muralists come down, and this is over on the stadium wall, the one near across from Kobach. This is Nayo, his daughter, and Doc.
Okay. So they're interacting with these guys, and it was a always a great session of music.
He's a real sweet teacher, really good with the kids. That's what he kind of lives for. This year they'll be working with the municipal juvenile band and the Estudiantina Infantil, and they hopefully will be part of our parade. Keep going.
Go ahead.
The workshops are usually done with your quarters, really easy to bring down and be reused, and they go over basic, the kids pick them up real quick. Doc's good at learning by ear, and he works with those kids by ear. He learned later to read the notes and music, but he's big on learning by ear. There's the end of the day, the workshop. Then the other area that we work in is humanitarian and medical. We work have a fire department exchange, police department exchange, and we've had an ambulance donation. We have medical brigades with surgical clinics and medical equipment donations. We work with water quality on testing and purification projects. We've done backpack drives and bicycle drives.
This is a session with the Scottsdale Fire Chief, with the Alamos crew that was there. He's explaining how they cover the large area of Scottsdale with fire services. We have first aid training with from the Scottsdale Fire Department trainers with the Alamos firefighters.
This year they've asked us to send one policeman up with them because they wanted him to get the training. I suspect he'll be doing the training and training the others.
You're doing good, Errol. Scottsdale Department donated air tanks and packs to the firemen, the Alamos firemen that were here, and they also included probably 15 or 20 air tanks A lot of this stuff, they have to change out after 10 years of use. And usually the case is that this continues to be usable. So it can be passed on to people like the Alamos Fire Department.
And Scottsdale has asked, well, what is your needs? What do you need? And the Alamos people come back, well, what's the list of stuff you have? And we'll put a priority on that. So we're still working with that communication for this year. We're trying to have an exchange in March. We're working on visas, and we're using our state senator, Mark Kelly, they all have their dates now and it's scheduled for 2004. They just got the dates back last week. And through our senator, he'll contact the consulate's office, and U.S. consulate's office, and try and push the dates up to have a March 2023 exchange.
Nice. Go ahead. So here are the police department exchange. And anyway, they got exposed to a lot of stuff. What do you want to add?
No, anything? No, okay. I'm Guadalupe. I'm laughing. Go ahead. Yeah. Stun gun. Yeah.
Of course, we probably won't have robotics here, but this is an example of their bomb crew demonstration. And traditionally, the police and fire crews stay in a fire station, and we, at the end of the exchange, pull together a carne asada presentation, and the group gets to spend some relaxed social time together eating a Mexican meal. And this is in one of the fire stations.
That the Alamos police officers and firemen prepare for the crews that they've been working with.
Or anyway, this is the recent ceremony around the ambulance. Mayor Ortega presenting Presidente Valderrama the keys to the ambulance. And it is down here in Alamos now. And you want to go ahead and continue, Errol?
Through Dale Gray of Sustainable Outreach Solutions, he had access to like 6 ambulances, and they dedicated one to go to Alamos, also in conjunction with the Rotary Group. Completely.
They're fully outfitted, supplies, gurneys.
Here it is, finally in Alamos. It took about 2 years.
Well, caught up in COVID and all that good stuff. Next one, okay. And then Jim of the Hacienda was concerned that people may not understand that there's outside communities helping Alamos. So he donated this sign for the ambulance, so people recognize where things are coming from.
One of the presidencies asked for medical help. And actually Max Rumbaugh went asking, and that's when he became acquainted with Dale Gray and Sustainable Outreach Solutions. And they have been doing surgical clinics around the world, and they offered to do one here. They had a gynecological clinic. They've had it several years now. And they bring the laparoscopic equipment down and train the Mexican gynecological surgeons.
Next, Errol.
So they here is a follow-up. Keep going. So the Americans surgeons first start out doing the surgery and having the Mexican surgeons assist. And then the next day, the Mexican surgeon will step in and the American surgeon assists. And then on the other days, the Mexican surgeons are taking over.
So these surgical techniques really involve small incisions on the person's body with the devices going in, the cameras and the tools they're using. Doesn't require a big slash in the gut and opening up, so it's very less impactful, and they're able to view what they're doing via video, and they're looking at the screen there, and then I think the next picture shows you what they're looking at.
So it takes a lot of practice manipulating the tools and getting used to the camera, and it's a lot quicker recovery because it's a lot less damage done. Next slide. Ms. Maria Hayward and her daughter, Noily Ellenberger, and she was one of the surgical gynecologists.
Next.
Crew.
So these sessions are a week long. Other things are getting
medical equipment. Álamos requested the medical equipment, and I guess when the SOS stepped in, they worked with Rotary, and they ended up collecting in Project Care, and they ended up having two container loads go to six different hospitals in Sonora. We went in and previewed the hospitals, looked at their needs and requests, and then they sent two container loads, had them packed up in the order that they were getting dumped off. And then I haven't heard that there was to be a follow-up to see that the equipment got there, stayed there, and was being used. Loading up the container. On the water project, we're out in Los Estrados, and Dale Gray is giving a water demonstration. You take a bucket with water, and you go and pick up the dirt on the ground, and you throw it, and you throw another group of it, stir it up, and have them look at the water. Then they take a simple filtration filter, like you use for backpacking, and filter it out, and then they drink the water, and you offer them to drink the water, too. It's really wonderful. Way to do it. Rotary, I think, came through with a lot of funding for the filters. So it's wonderful in outlying communities where water might hopefully is available. Clean it. Then we went around and did a water testing thing, maybe 15, all the places that feed water to Álamos, testing them. This was one of the stations. Neat. This was one that had the solar panels that pumped the water into town. And the results of this testing is the water was perfect. There was any problem with it. They said they didn't have chlorine levels, but they asked, should we be turning the chlorine on when you're doing the testing? And they told them no. Mm-hmm. So whatever, a little bit skewed that way. The water's all brought in. Most of it comes from Sabanita Sur. It's brought into three big containers. I don't know if you've seen them, one way out past El Barranco, the other one on the hill. As you're coming into town on the site over by the excavated mountain. And the third one, I'm not sure where it's thin.
Backpack drive. We asked elementary schools to gather used backpacks at the end of school. And then we bring them down here and circulate them with the kids to help them get their supplies between home and class.
Keep going.
And this gives you an idea of what the schools look like out in a remote community, and the kids are all grateful. Look at that, all their backpacks.
I'm still picking up backpacks on Dollar Day at Goodwill. If you guys come across backpacks where the zippers are working, if you can pick those up, and each week I collect a couple and start getting, have about 20 days, get out to, usually they go up to the Guadalajara community. If anyone comes across that resource, it'd be wonderful.
Thanks, Cheryl. We also organized there was a request to help provide buses to take kids from the remote communities into a centralized school location. And that was difficult to do. It took us years to get an ambulance. You can imagine how long it'd be to get a bus. Anyway, so we came up with this idea of why not use bicycles? So we gathered up 50 bicycles to represent 50 years of our relationship, and they were distributed out into the rural communities.
And this would help the high school kids get into where there's internet connection, and they could be attending high school on the internet connection.
This is sporting goods equipment. We had a drive for that and help augment their sports program.
Each year we kind of select a different area to focus on for the drives.
And so this is when the delegations come from Álamos to Scottsdale, and we have the reverse down here. But anyway, this is with our current mayor in Scottsdale, David Ortega.
and Presidente Victor Valderrama and his group. This is Benjamin Presidente Anaya touring a bicycle shop that recycles bicycles and distributed in the community in Scottsdale. Next. They also were interested in a water treatment plant. So that's there. And I think you had the impression anyway that this is a top-notch recycling.
Yeah, that people come from all over the world to see how it's done.
And making friends at Pueblo during one of the visits.
The Scottsdale president, mayor up visiting Scottsdale.
Next.
The end of that visit, that day at Pueblo Elementary School.
Next. I think it's the Arizona League of Cities and Towns organized this.
Statewide sister city program. Every sister city, every town in Arizona that has a sister city in Sonora, we all met. And so we had the Alamos contingent up to work with us on it.
Next.
Met in small groups. There's Mayor Lane and Victor Valderrama, and did some brainstorming on how we could come up with better relations.
Next.
Mayor Lane, Victor Valderrama.
Mayor Lane presented what our committee came up with, and it's kind of interesting if you can see those things. One is dealing with, now I can't even read it very well, it's the Sonora only zone.
Making Sonora a free zone.
Which hasn't happened yet, unfortunately. And then consolidating freight inspections. I don't know if that's been achieved, but we also, the sharing of cultural events.
About performers to Scottsdale, yes, about performers to Scottsdale, and then U.S. Performers to Alamos. And we've accomplished that, making Alamos Airport an international airport. Jim Swicker's been working on that for ages. And then the Alamos Convention Center, and that's been accomplished.
Which, yeah. And one of their visits happened to dovetail with the Sonora governor visiting. She made her speech before the Rotary Club there. And that's
happened to be at the time that our police exchange was up here, and they got to be with her.
Mm-hmm. Next. And this is the students in front of our Sister City sign next to City Hall in Scottsdale. And you'll take a quick moment to read this. We've come to our end.
Okay. Now, if you have questions, either here in the audience or online, Bob and Katherine can answer.
We hope.
Just in general, how is this organization funded?
Through memberships, we have fundraising events, and we do get a small grant from the city of Scottsdale each year. And so if we're short funds for certain things, we go out and gather particular things like student exchanges when they go overseas, which are really expensive, and we're helping to provide scholarships for the folks that can't necessarily afford it. And there's a program where you can donate tax deductible money to the school districts for those specific programs. So that's one of the ways we fund the students' exchanges that are difficult.
And does the Alamos side of it provide any?
Well, when we're doing things together, like the jazz festival, they're providing all the sound equipment, the lighting, the stage. Yeah. They're helping us get the promotional pieces together to hire the Filler Big Band. They'll be doing the Lona. Yes, there is on both sides. To get the students up, their response, the city often will, or they'll get the Kobach van out of Hermosillo. They'll provide their transportation up there. Yes, it's both sides.
And this is the sister city itself. Are you incorporating your 501c3
or
so the donations can be
directed
to?
Correct.
For specific specific programs too.
Any other things?
Bob, may I ask you if you have some printed?
We do not have any with us. We have a few membership brochures in Scottsdale. We didn't bring any with us.
Is there a website?
Yes.
But what an excellent opportunity. I think it would be great to know more about it. Do you have anything that could be disseminated or told about or something?
Scottsdale Sister Cities has a website which has all of that information on it and a way to apply to for membership.
And they have a newsletter that comes out, keeping you up to date on all the events. And doing group trips, we should have a busload of 20 Scottsdale citizens coming down for the jazz festival. They'll be staying at the Hotel Plaza, and they'll be joining in on different Scottsdale Sister City events, we're hoping. But they always need more people that'd be willing to sign up for those trips.
Scottsdale Sister Cities Association.
I will send out a link.
Okay, thanks, Cheryl.
What are the dates?
It's March 10th and 11th, Friday and Saturday night. Mm-hmm. Oh, and you're welcome to come up to any of the workshops. There's a Kulbach workshop probably around 9 or 10 o'clock on Friday, and 4 o'clock up at the Casa de la Cultura. They'll be working with the Estudiantina, the Children's Estudiantina, and the Children's Municipal Band. Then the things are changing a little bit because we can't be on the plaza until the mass is done at 7. But we'll have the parade 6:30 or so, and then the concert will start at the Templo del Callejón at 7, and then they'll move on. They're moving on to Les Blues in the evening, and there'll be a backup band starting earlier at Les Blues if it takes them longer to get there.
And we will be circulating digitally schedule and some posters and things like that in town. So,
is there something on the website already?
No.
We're just pulling the schedule getting the room and board for the artists working out and ordering the equipment.
You'll have it by March 12th.
Yes, March 10th.
March 10th. Yeah.
They should be driving in on the 9th.
I have a question, Katherine. Can you hear me, Katherine and Bob?
Yes, I can. Yeah. Thanks, Melanie.
Hi. What's been the effect of over 50 years of this program? Have the students grown up and become, you know, continue their interest in each other's areas?
Well, we haven't actually kept track of the kids, but sometimes we do. I have kids that are, you know, out of the program will run up to me during these festivals that I'm at right now and say hello, and I'll always check up and see where they are, and they're at the university or they're teachers or raising families. It's quite nice.
And with how long have we been active in it? Is it 9
probably
years?
Probably 10, yeah, 9 10, or 10 years.
10 years. The prior ones, I don't know if they had student exchanges. They may have been doing exchanges with some of the other schools in other cities.
Well, Francis had a program, exchanges before Max got involved.
Okay.
So,
well, it's fascinating. Yeah. Thanks for sharing.
Oh, you're welcome. Thank you for listening.
Okay. Well, I want to thank Bob and Katherine for that. I should have introduced Katherine. I didn't realize she would be contributing so much to this, but Katherine is an artist and has they both have houses right here. I want to say that I will send out the web link, and sister, if you've not been involved in Sister Cities, wherever you live, it is a wonderful organization, and they have student exchanges, they have cultural exchanges. And I'm so happy that you were able to present with what has happened between Álamos and its sister city of Scottsdale. Next week, I want to tell you we're having a special program. We will not meet here in the auditorium, but next week, February 2nd at 1 o'clock,
we will be at Bartolome School. We'll get a tour of the school. You'll see a classroom, education in progress, and we'll learn the history of the building and its 110-year history as a school. So I hope all of you can come there. You know where Bartolome School is, right there by the museum. And it'll be a great, great opportunity. Okay, I guess we will close the meeting. I want to thank all of you for coming and all of you online. Thank you very much.